Welcome, fans, to this week's episode of Dashboard, powered by Monolith Technology Group and, well, me, your host, Jana. Last week was a bit of a data dump. To catch up, check it out on this link here. This episode, I thought I would keep it light with some tips, tricks, and reviews. So let's fire up the dashboard. So, a fun fact that I think you guys can relate to is I get absurd data charges for the content I share with my friends and coworkers. So much quality is lost in the transfer that it's hardly worth the cost. When it comes to the best ways to share pictures, I have learned a thing or two. For those of you with iPhone, use AirDrop instead of iMessage, Messenger, WhatsApp, etc. With no cost of bandwidth and minimal compression, most pictures maintain their original quality. No more blaming your phone if a picture you thought was awesome and cute isn't. On a more professional note, if you're in a pinch to scan a document or just don't want to line up at the bank these days, use apps such as Cam Scanner or ScanBot, both for Android, and ScanBot for iOS. These apps instantly scan, format, and save documents as PDFs for sharing. What do you guys prefer for mobile scanning apps? Let me know in the comments below. And I don't know if anyone else has experienced this in the past few months, but I've gotten pretty familiar with Zoom, but I haven't taken the time to really take advantage of its features. Great for team huddles and formal conferences. Personally, I use it on the hourly for work check-ins, conferences with family, and virtual happy hours. Through trial and error, I give you my top three suggestions and shortcuts for Zoom. One, instead of missing your chance to speak or ask a question, try using the space bar to temporarily unmute yourself. This is a decent shortcut when you want to jump in on a discussion. Two, if you want to hide the clutter at your domestic desk, try changing your virtual background. Or maybe you just want to keep your home space more private to other attendees. Either way, adding this background is a fun way to do so. And three, try the breakout room feature to make meetings more dynamic or to separate departments. Hosts can call back participants at any time, and I find it breaks up long conferences really nicely. One last Zoom tip and a warning to the multitaskers among us. Hosts now have the ability to enable a function called attention tracking, which identifies participants that have clicked off the active Zoom window for more than 30 seconds. Well, that's a lot to try out. These are simple tricks to help you run the show while you're on the go or at home. That's it for now. Oh yeah, one more thing. As promised, this week on Dashboard, we are unveiling our new segment called Code Red. What that means for you is you get insider info on our latest contests, promotions, and giveaways. What do we have for you? Glad you asked. This week, we are giving away the new Intel 10th Gen processor to one lucky subscriber. For contest details, follow us on social media at Monolith Tech. And subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on future Code Red and Dashboard content. You can also find us on social media and on our website, monolithgroup.ca. I'm Jana, this is Dashboard, and we'll see you next week.